The Ballad of Andy and Barney. Andy and Barney were lawmen, bravest you ever did see. Warned every crook in the record book to stay out of Mayberry. They were the law.
Yes, they were the law, and they didn't know fear.
The Andy Griffith Show.
I guess to sum it up, you could say there's three reasons why there's so little crime in Mayberry. There's Andy, and there's me, and baby makes three.
Now on MeTV Fresno.
Must watch news channel in Europe.
Attention all units. We have reports of two motorcycle cops protecting California's highway.
That's for us, good buddy.
The Men of Chips are on MeTV.
Hi, I'm John Baker.
I'm John Baker.
It's Officer Baker.
He's the blonde one.
Hi there.
Officer Poncherello, man.
Frank Poncherello.
Oh, I'm Frank Poncherello.
And he's the one who's Eric Estrada.
There's no way I wouldn't remember a name like that.
Catch the blonde one and the one who's Eric Estrada.
Now
Chips.
On MeTV Fresno, Xfinity 187.
Hi, I'm John Malice. Welcome to this live edition of Connect With Me on the showroom floor at Ventura TV on this day. Today, a pair of guests. One is a congressman from right here in the Central Valley. We'll take your phone calls at 436-MeTV, option 11. Then the second half of the program, we've got a championship boxer in the house today. He's going to St. Petersburg, Russia next week to compete in the World Boxing Championships. A heck of a show ahead here on Connect With Me on MeTV Fresno, Comcast now. Channel 375. And welcome back to the program here on Connect With Me. I'm glad you're here. And this week we changed channels on Comcast. It's now 375 as opposed to 187. That's the old homicide channel that we were on, 187. And now we're on 375. But we're also on over-the-air broadcast, 43.6, 13.1, and 8.1. And then, my friends, you can watch the replay of this program each and every Monday through Friday. Like, for example, today, you can check us out at 2 o'clock on 13.6 YouTube, 8 o'clock primetime, 4.6 Biz TV, and then 24 hours a day on, of course, YouTube. The Twitter account has not changed. It is exactly the same at John Malos MeTV. And I should say that today's program is sponsored by our friends at Guzman, McGill, Guzman. Chuck McGill is the defense attorney. He's been around here for many years, the better part of a quarter century here in the Central Valley. So thank you, Chuck, for the sponsorship today. Quick mention about the program tomorrow. We're talking with Sharon Johnson. She is from the Komen Center, of course, talking about the breast cancer race that's coming up in October. There is also a breast cancer screening program that's taking place in September. We'll talk about that. And there'll be a second guest in the studio tomorrow to talk about breast cancer as well. Then on Monday, our friend over at KMPH Fox 26, Eric Rosales. I get a kick out of watching this guy. He's the best investigative reporter in town. He will be here on Monday to talk to us about how do you do that. Eric Rosales of KMPH Fox 26. So today we're going to talk a little bit about this shooting that took place yesterday morning on the East Coast in Roanoke, Virginia. I want to roll the videotape, my friends, because this was so devastating to me, having been in broadcasting for so many years, the better part of 40 years now. First time I've ever seen this on live television. 24-year-old Allison Parker, 27-year-old Adam Ward, a reporter and photographer, shot on live TV by Bryce Williams, a former reporter at WDBJ Roanoke, the CBS affiliate there. Williams, a.k.a. Vester Flanagan, apparently was a disgruntled former employee claims he was discriminated against. So apparently he had planned this for months, legally purchased the gun, killed Allison Parker, killed Adam Ward, injured another woman who was being interviewed on live television. So eventually, during the course of the morning on Wednesday, Williams took his own life as he was being chased by authorities on the highway. And so he committed suicide, took his own life, as well as the lives of those two right there, Allison Parker, Adam Ward. And of course, condolences going out to all of their families. And so this brings up the question about gun control. You heard it this morning on some of the news broadcasts. Gun control once again being brought into the picture. Is it an issue? Well, my friends, live in our studio right now to talk about this and many other topics is our friend here, Congressman Devin Nunes of the 22nd Congressional District. He is the chairman of the House Permanent Select Committee on Intelligence. He was nominated by John Boehner. The Congress, of course, approved that nomination. He is here to talk about Benghazi, ISIS, Donald Trump, and yes, this awful, terrible tragedy that took place yesterday in Roanoke, Virginia, something that I had feared that would happen eventually somewhere across the country now has happened. But does that bring up the issue of gun control again? I don't know. 436 MeTV Option 11. We're back here on our program in just a moment.
Have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights. With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from McGill, Guzman, McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
Retro TV, your home for classic television. The greatest shows in history are here for you to enjoy. Join Cosby and Culp as secret agent men in I Spy. Ride along the Ponderosa with the Cartwrights in Bonanza. Hit the beat with Joe Friday in Dragnet. And that's not all. Retro TV offers endless fun and excitement for the whole family to enjoy. Retro TV, the best in classic television.
You can find Retro TV on over-the-air channel 13.4.
Despicable act that took place on live television yesterday, and that station was WDBJ, the CBS affiliate in Roanoke, Virginia. Allison Parker, 24 years old, was interviewing somebody from the Chamber of Commerce at 6:45 in the morning, Eastern Time yesterday. Her and her photographer, Adam Ward, shot to death by a former disgruntled employee, Bryce Williams, a.k.a. Vester Flanagan, apparently fired by the station a couple of years ago. He claims it was discrimination, and again this morning we're hearing, hey, is this about gun control? I don't know. Congressman Devin Nunes is here. Good to see you.
Hey John, it's great to be on again.
Congressman, thank you for being here. I appreciate it. Is this about gun control or not?
Well, anytime an act of violence like this happens, it's always people like to dumb it down to the gun. But it's not about guns. It's about people who are mentally disturbed. And, you know, I'd have to question, how is it that this person purchased this gun legally when clearly, you know, he had some issues, some mental issues. So hopefully this, you know, that people just remain vigilant, and people who sell guns have to be very careful about who they sell guns to. But in the future, this stuff's going to happen. But the question that always remains is we have a right under our Constitution to carry guns in this country. And you know, they're heavily regulated by the states. They're heavily regulated as to what kind of guns that we can get. And here in California, it's one of the most regulated places in the United States. So I would say that this is not talking about having more gun control. It's about making sure the laws that are on the books for gun control actually work while allowing law-abiding citizens to continue to have their Second Amendment rights under the Constitution.
I heard Governor Chris Christie of New Jersey this morning on the news say this is not about gun control. We have enough laws on the books. We're just not enforcing them. Is he right?
I think that's accurate. Yeah. I mean, look, and the problem is the people who always promote more gun control, at the end of the day, it'll be the criminals who will end up with the guns, and it'll be the law-abiding citizens who will end up without the guns. And that's not a position that we want to put the American people into.
Is it about mental illness?
A lot of it is. A lot of it is. If you look at, they're kind of, it's twofold right now, right? You have people who have mental illnesses that create these horrible crimes. But then secondly, and more importantly, you have domestic terrorism some of these radical jihadists now that are being radicalized over the internet, who have started to open up fire, just like the attack that you saw last weekend, where three Americans were able in Paris, on the train from Paris, and they were able to stop the gunman in his tracks. But those would be my two concerns, both mental illness and dealing with radical jihadists.
One more question about this and we'll move on. And certainly my heart goes out to the families. And I saw the interview with the father of Allison Parker this morning on the news, and it's hard just stop short of just breaking down and crying for that family. Horrible. We see it overseas all the time. Journalists getting killed, kidnapped, maimed, tortured. We're not used to that in this country, especially on a live television show.
Yeah, and it's one of the most horrific things that I've ever seen, to do it on live television like that. It's truly one of those things that we'll never forget, and we just have to be vigilant.
Yeah, and one quick thing before we go to break here, we'll come on back and talk about some other things. If it is about mental illness, Congressman, what can we do about it to help people that are disgruntled, a disgruntled former employee? How do we help somebody like that?
So I always say that dealing with these folks is always done best at the local level. So it's making sure that the local agencies, because every county, every city is different on how they deal with mental illness throughout the country. And we're just trying to make sure that our local agencies are doing their job.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, caller, you're on the air. Go ahead. Hang on one second. Having a hard time hearing you. Go ahead.
Somebody. Then we have a drunk driver kills somebody. Why don't we just get rid of all alcohol? I mean, it makes the same sense. I'm not advocating either one, but the liberals, immediately go for gun control. When the guy purchased the gun legally, he did everything legally, but it was all in his head. You know, the guy was a wacko. So, again, if you're going to ban one, ban the other one.
Banning alcohol? I don't know. If you ban guns, you have to ban alcohol too.
I think the point the caller was making was that there's a lot of things that cause people to commit crimes.
Yeah.
And it's not the gun, so to speak, or it's not alcohol, so to speak, but it's the abuse of either or.
Yeah, that's right. We're talking with Congressman Devin Nunes. We're glad he's in the House today. He is from the 22nd Congressional District. We're going to come back and talk about ISIS. We're going to come back and talk about these three men, actually four men now, that really saved the day in Paris, and also talk a little bit about Donald Trump. I mean, why not? Everybody else is. Why shouldn't we? 436-ME-TV, option 11. We're back in just a moment.
Have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights. With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from McGill, Guzman, McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
Back here on the program with Congressman Devin Nunes, 22nd Congressional District. He is also the chair of the House Permanent Select Committee on Intelligence. Okay, caller, you're there. Go ahead. You're on the air.
Thank you. My question is this. That Ronald Reagan shut off the mental health system and shut down, and people were just trying like heck, trying to survive, like the woman in Selma that was in a wheelchair and she needed $3,000 a month in pills to live, and he shut her off. Now, the whole system has not recovered from this, and what we have to do is go back and reinstate, prior to Ronald Reagan, mental health, so these people can get the help they need and get off the street. People, one of the killers just here in the last couple of years was like 8 times his mother called in and demanded help, and she just was totally ignored. and I don't mean California, but I mean the whole nationwide. The health system is out of whack. Let's get it back in whack prior, before Ronald Reagan.
Okay.
Because we weren't having all these problems before Ronald Reagan destroyed the mental health system entirely.
Go ahead.
Well, I think this part of the problem. I'm not exactly sure what specific law that the caller's talking about, because you're talking about the 1980s, which has now been many years ago. But the fact of the matter is that my assumption of what Ronald Reagan was trying to do is what we continue to do at the federal level, which is the Washington, D.C. cannot deal with mental health issues at a local level. And what we try to do in Congress, what I always try to do, is get Washington, D.C. out of the business of trying to control people's lives or get in the way of local government. So the best thing that we can possibly do is continue to get rid of the strings that Washington has attached to any federal dollars. There's not a lot of federal dollars that go to mental health, but locally, the dollars have always increased, and they continue to increase, especially here in California. We spend a lot of money on mental health issues. So it's about getting Washington, D.C., Sacramento out of the way and making sure that people can use the money locally here to deal with what's in the local area.
Yeah, makes sense. All right, I want to switch topics now and go to the ISIS video. New York Times recently reported here that officials at U.S. Central Command, that's CENTCOM, you know more about this than I do, altered some intelligence reports to make the fight against ISIS look more optimistic and presenting those reports not only to policymakers like yourself, but also the President of the United States, to give this visionary to everybody in Washington that we're winning the battle against ISIS on the ground. Is there any legs to this? Is there any truth to it? And if so, what can be done about it?
Well, what I've said consistently is that the policy that's in place, the ultimate strategy that is in place to deal with ISIS today, is at best a containment type of strategy. So when you have a containment strategy, that is not a way to defeat ISIS. There's no question that we are taking some really bad guys off the battlefield. Just this morning it came out that we were able to, this hasn't been, I'm not sure that this has been confirmed, but at least there's press reports that say that we took one of the radical jihadists that went from Great Britain, from the UK, went into Syria, and has been doing a lot of the radicalization over the internet. This is one of the people that supposedly were taken off the battlefield here in the last few days.
And so is that a key move?
Absolutely, because he's one of the top guys that we know who is doing a lot of the radicalization over the internet. So when we look at the gunman on the Paris train, we don't know all the background yet, but we know that that him and others are using the internet to become radicalized and to develop targets. And
we don't know if the gunman was associated with ISIS.
We don't. But we do know that others like him have been.
Okay.
So especially here in the United States. So a lot of the people that were wrapped up before July 4th, we know that they were being radicalized over the internet, and we know that the guy that was taken off the battlefield, this is one of the guys. But to your point, John, a containment strategy is not a strategy for victory.
Well, apparently someone from the Defense Intelligence Agency, DIA, spilled the beans about this. A senior military official confirmed to Fox News yesterday or the day before that an investigation has been launched. So we don't know much about this yet. But if this turns out to be true, you're giving falsified reports to the president and to people like yourself in Congress, and someone who is the chair of the Intelligence Committee. Is that a crime?
Well, I want to be careful to, I mean, this is just a one report and
right.
one.
You don't want to jump the gun.
We shouldn't jump the gun.
Yeah.
Because for the most part, remember, our military is out there doing very difficult work under very difficult circumstances. But it's the President of the United States, the White House, that has developed the strategy. And as I said, this is not a strategy that's designed for victory, because we are dealing with a generational fight here. ISIS is spread from Morocco all the way to Pakistan. You still have Al-Qaeda. In some ways, those groups are linked. Sometimes they fight, sometimes they're not, but the leaders of ISIS were Al-Qaeda leaders.
I saw one military official yesterday tell Congress when he was asked, is ISIS winning? Are we winning? Is it a standoff? Is it a stalemate? He says, no, it's a stalemate.
Yeah,
is he right?
Well, that would be the same thing I said about it being a
you just
a,
said that
a containment,
just a minute about a
containment
minute
strategy
yeah.
results in a stalemate. It
yeah.
doesn't result in victory.
Yeah, so we're at a stalemate right now. I've got a call coming in. Good morning, caller. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just think that we can't win a war against ISIS the way how we've been fighting our last wars. We really need to go ahead and clean out our prisons of all our undesirable, you know, killers, and just send them over there, give them some good weapons, and let them annihilate everything. Kind of like what they did to the Indians that were here first.
Right.
And we could take over their stuff.
Okay.
But other than that, I mean, that's all I got to say. What do you guys think about that?
Well, I appreciate the call very much. Thank you for watching. I've heard this argument before for many years. Take all of our prisoners, all the gangbangers, send them over there if they want to fight. That's not going to happen.
Well, it's not going to happen, number one, because it would be against the law. The
yeah.
people who broke the law are in prison for a reason. And I think more than that, ISIS and Al-Qaeda, these guys are seriously trained fighters. These guys wouldn't last a second out there because you know they just wouldn't even have the logistical arm to get food, know how to get food, know how to get to the battlefield, or know anything else. But to the caller's point, we know how to defeat these guys. We know how to go in there and get them.
Well, then, the problem for God's sake, why isn't the president doing it?
Because the president, I believe, doesn't want to put troops in harm's way. And you really have to build a coalition.
Yeah.
So when you talk about dealing with ISIS, you have to also look at North Africa. You see all the migrants that are coming across that are actually dying in the Mediterranean. They're trying to escape, get out of the control of ISIS or Al-Qaeda or radical jihadists. Many of those people are being trapped. Europe is under tremendous pressure, having to take these migrants in. And at some point, I think NATO or the European countries are going to have to develop a coalition with the United States. But our president has not been willing to put that coalition together, and that's why he's only using this containment strategy.
Wow. Okay. We're going to come back with Congressman Devin Nunes of the 22nd Congressional District. He is also the chairman of the Intelligence Committee here on this program today, and we're going to continue talking about ISIS. We'll talk about a couple of other things. He's got to leave at 10:30. So your phone call is 436-ME-TV, option 11. We're glad he's here. We're glad you're there. Back in a moment.
Have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights. With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from McGill, Guzman, McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
Back here on the program, and I'm glad that our friend Congressman Devin Nunes is here to talk about this. We'll talk one more item regarding ISIS, of course. And the bombing started last August, just 1 year ago, and still we're here talking with the congressman today about containment. Is that really getting the job done? The thing I want to bring up is Turkey. Turkey is supposed to be our ally. We have bases there. I do have a call, but hang on, caller, one moment, please. I'll put you on with the congressman in just a moment. My question to you is, I've read several articles in the past week or so, articles that have been emailed to me regarding Turkey. It sounds to me, and these articles are suggesting that Turkey is supporting many of these jihadist radical groups that support ISIS or are aligned with ISIS, and they're conspiring to commit these terror acts, not only in this country, but abroad. So where do we stand with Turkey? I guess that's my question.
Mm-hmm. So your question, we would need about four programs to answer your question. But a lot of what you see in the Middle East is there because of the breakup of the Ottoman Empire after World War I, where many atrocities happened.
Hang on, caller.
And when you look at that, how those lines were drawn by the Brits and others, a lot of the nation states that were created don't even make a lot of sense. And so I think part of what you're seeing is what happened 100 years ago, we are now paying the price for the lines that were drawn. But it's gotten so big now because you have the jihadists that are everywhere, including in Turkey. And so Turkey is run now by a guy who I consider to be almost a dictator to some degree. Yeah. Historically, you know, they were a pretty good ally. Now you have to really question what their motivation is, because that country in and of itself is and arguably falling apart.
Whose side are they on? That's the question. We don't know. I don't know.
I don't think they know.
Yeah. Caller, go ahead. You're on with the congressman.
Yeah, let me ask the congressman. I think it's hard for me to understand that when President like Obama doesn't do this and that. I mean, he went back to the Bush era. Forget the president, okay? I think the whole issue is this. There's no way we're going to be able to take care of them as far as going in there with drones and bombing, you know, where there might be or whatever, because there's civilians in there, okay? That's number one. And the thing is that at one time we used to be the strongest, you know, Air Force, everything, Marines and everything in the world. Now, they're not even afraid of us. Well, you got Russia, you got China, you got, you know, other countries that say, hey, they're not going to do anything to us, so we can get stronger, whatever.
Yeah.
I think what we have to do is concentrate here in the United States with our own problem as far as, you know, gun control. The issue would happen with the crew, and I felt for the journalists and whatnot, had to be a mental issue.
Okay. Thank you. I guess nobody fears us is his question. You know, he made that comment. Nobody fears the United States anymore. Is that true?
No. Look, they know that we have the fiercest military in the world. We still have the best technology in the world. But I do believe the caller's right about one thing, and that is we can't do it on our own. So we can only do it with a coalition that understands that the strategy has to be a generational strategy. This is going to have to be dealt with by, you know, President Bush called it a generational war. President Obama tried to say that the wars were over. I think President Obama learned in office that the wars were not over and that it is a generational fight. You now have President Obama saying the same thing that President Bush did. And the next president's going to have to deal with this, including probably the next three or four presidents. Yeah. But it's going to take a coalition of the willing dealing with the strongest leaders that we have in the Middle East to work with us.
Okay, we got about 3 or 4 minutes left here, and then I know you have to go, and I want to touch on a couple of other things. Caller, are you there? Go ahead.
Caller? Hello?
Yeah, short on time. Go ahead. What's your question, quickly? Thank you.
Yes, one question. Is he for, against, or haven't decided on the nuclear treaty with Iran?
Okay.
Oh, as well as who... do you see Biden getting into the race?
Okay, thank you.
That's a great question. So with the Iranian nuclear deal, I think this is a real critical mistake. I think it's going to make things a lot worse. It's going to be rejected by the Congress overwhelmingly.
How about the Senate?
The House and Senate will reject it overwhelmingly, but we don't know if it will get 2/3.
Oh,
I think
okay.
there'll be 60%, but I don't know if there'll be the 67%. And that should tell the president something. But the president believes, the president wants to get us out of war. And that's a nice thought. But the problem is that wars don't end until one side gives up. And the jihadists haven't given up. And I put the Iranians in the same category as the jihadists because they use a lot of the same tactics.
Yeah. I want to change topics here. I only got a couple of minutes left. I know you got to run. Let's go to the Donald Trump either picture or video. Latest poll today, Donald Trump up 28%. That's a national poll. Ben Carson, 12%. Jeb Bush, 7%. I know you can't endorse any candidate. It's way too early. But what do you make of what's happening with Donald Trump? In his own mind, I don't know if he thinks he can win. He's battling with Megyn Kelly. He's battling with Jorge Ramos of Univision. He's battling with the media constantly, yet he's way ahead in the polls despite his stance on immigration and abortion and all these other issues. What do you make of what's going on in the Republican race just now, just standing back and looking?
Well, the first thing is that Donald Trump is is very entertaining to watch. And he's doing, you know, he's doing a lot of things that that a lot of people in politics would never do, and it makes for great entertainment. You know, I think the question will still remain when you actually start to, when voters start to focus in and evaluate, okay, can this person not only lead, but can, do they also have policies that make sense and that could pass the Congress and become law, and can you work with people? And yeah, look, we'll leave it up to the voters to decide.
It's entertaining, though, isn't it?
It absolutely is.
I get up, if I'm in a bad mood, I turn it on, I see Trump, I start laughing, I'm in a great mood the rest of the day.
Yeah. You need to have him on your show here.
Quickly, because we only got about a minute left. Hillary Clinton, two questions about her. Are these emails, the issue about the personal emails using government, the personal server for government work and emails, is that going to bring her down? And secondly, before the election next year, is she going to be called back to your committee or any committee to be questioned on Benghazi?
Well, she's supposed to testify before the Benghazi committee soon. The bigger question that we don't have the answers to yet is that how did classified information come out of off of classified systems and end up on her servers? And those questions have to be answered. I'm not going to pass judgment until the investigation's done, but you know, clearly you have an investigation by the FBI and by the Congress, and we have to get to the bottom of it, because leaking classified information being out on unclassified systems, no matter if it's Hillary Clinton's network,
her personal server,
yeah,
right?
Her personal server or anyone else's, is highly illegal and can be very damaging to our country's intelligence community.
Will that damage your run to the White House?
I think it already has, because it's really unexplainable how those ended up on her server and in her inbox, and she didn't notice that she had classified information.
All right, one last thing, and I'll let you go. Spencer Stone, Alec Scarlatos, Anthony Sadler, not household names across the country. These are the three, and there's a fourth, three Americans that saved the day overseas, subduing that gunman on a high-speed train in Paris. He had an AK-47. There were 500 passengers. Should they have a ticker tape parade either in D.C. or New York City? These guys are heroes.
They absolutely are, and not only that, but they're actually from Sacramento.
I know they are, my hometown.
And they've already been given an award by the President of France.
That's right.
I assume that they'll be honored by our government, and I assume even by our state and local government.
Yeah, they were honored up there. One was honored up in Sacramento just yesterday, I believe, by Mayor Kevin Johnson in front of City Hall. So to me, I'd take them to New York, ticker tape parade. They belong. They are heroes. They
And thank God they did that, because you know that gunman could have easily killed dozens of people.
Yeah. Congressman Devin Nunes,
thanks for having me on again.
God bless you.
All right. Stay safe. Thank you, sir.
And thank you for appearing here, and we'll see you again soon.
Absolutely.
Okay. Congressman Devin Nunes, the 22nd Congressional District, House Permanent Select Committee on Intelligence. He is the chairman. We thank him for his time. Our second guest is waiting in the wings. Back in a moment here on Connect with Me.
Have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights. With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from McGill, Guzman, McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
It's almost time.
Now we'll find out once and for all about Clark Kent, Superman.
Look up in the sky. It's a bird. It's a plane. It's a TV show.
Yes, but who is he? What's his name?
He's Superman.
Golly, Clark, won't that be wonderful seeing Superman?
Fighting a never-ending battle for truth, justice, and television the MeTV way.
No one can do the things that Superman does.
The Adventures of Superman.
Now on MeTV Fresno, Xfinity 187.
Hello, I'm John Walsh. We need your help to capture this fugitive. Francisco Molina Nieve has been on the run since March 2008. The police and the FBI need your help tracking this coward down. He's wanted for brutally beating his girlfriend and for the use of a firearm. He has three freckles and a crescent shape under his right eye. Call the Colorado FBI at 303-629-7171 if you know where he's hiding.
Is taking care of laundry taking too much of your time? Have you become a missing mom? With a new, fast, efficient washer and dryer from Ventura TV Video Appliance, you'll spend more of your day the way you want. Save now on Frigidaire's Advanced Affinity Laundry Pair. Let Frigidaire save you energy, water, and time. Don't spend your life on laundry. Upgrade today at Ventura TV Video Appliance and save.
Top secret location. It's the spies who love me, bringing together MeTV's top super spies to fight evil at a memorable moment's notice. They're daring.
That's right.
Brave.
Now what are we gonna do?
Best we can.
Suave.
Does that apply to me, Oscar?
Possibly.
And smart?
The old finger in the gun trick.
Maxwell Smart.
MeTV Fresno, channel 43.6 and Xfinity 187.
Frigidaire. We introduce the first home freezer. The first pulsator agitator washer. And now we introduce the Frigidaire Orbit Clean Dishwasher, designed with a unique wash arm that gives you four times more water coverage for a consistently better clean. Frigidaire, over 90 years of legendary innovation. See the full line of Frigidaire appliances at Ventura TV Electronics and Appliances.
Back here on the program, our thanks again to Congressman Devin Nunes, the 22nd Congressional District, of course, the chairman of the Intelligence Committee. Now time to change pace here and talk about a little bit about boxing. You know, we have a championship boxer right here in our own area. He is a high school student, and next week he'll be traveling overseas to take place in the World Boxing Championships, my friends. Let's roll the videotape, and I'll show you exactly what I'm talking about. A great young man, has a lot of championship belts already. To his credit, his name is Mark Castro. He is in the, wow, look at that, he's wearing those green boxing shoes. I love that. Mark Castro, a student at Sunnyside High School. He carries a 3.7 grade point average. Not bad considering all the work it takes him to train, travel, and box. His father is Tony. He's the coach. They usually get in shape at Sanger Boxing Gym, where Mark has been going there for years. And those at the gym who have watched him grow say he is a very humble kid who has a huge and positive influence on some of the other younger fighters. Mark leaves next Friday, September the 4th, for St. Petersburg, Russia. And it will be there that he'll be trying to bring home a championship belt of his own from those world championship fights. For the last 5 years, Castro has been a dominant fighter. He has amassed a very impressive record, 93 wins, 6 losses. He has traveled extensively throughout the country, Nevada, Tennessee, West Virginia, and other parts. These are the junior boxing matches, and they are 2 3-minute rounds and certainly not much room for air, which means that you have to size up your opponent within a matter of seconds. He's been training for the last 2 months for that big trip going to St. Petersburg, Russia. And what a trip it will be. He'll be there for the better part of 2 weeks, maybe more. Live in our studio right now is Mark Castro, 16 years old, headed to Russia, my friends, the World Boxing Championships. He leaves next Friday, September the 4th, and sitting in front of him are just a few, and I say just a few, of the championship belts he has. We'll have them hold some of those belts up. Him and his family are here in the studio today. As a matter of fact, Mark's family brought in an entire suitcase filled with these championship belts. We can't even display them all. It's incredible. Anyway, Mark Castro is here, 436-ME-TV, option 11. Call in, congratulate him, and send him off to St. Petersburg, Russia with a blessing. 436-ME-TV, option 11. Our sponsor today is Guzman McGill Guzman.
Have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights. With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from McGill, Guzman, McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
Take a look at this. Let's play.
This is too hip for you. I'll slow down.
Watch all your favorite classic game shows on Buzzer TV, KVBC Digital Channel 13.7.
Back here talking sports, my friends. Next to Friday, September the 4th, not tomorrow, but the next week, our friend Mark Castro, 16 years old from Sunnyside High School, is going to St. Petersburg, Russia. What a trip for a 16-year-old to go over there and box in several of these two-minute round matches. And it's the World Boxing Championships, and you're right here in our own backyard. How are you, Mark? Good morning.
I'm doing well. Thank you. Thank
you for having me. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Oh, well, thank you for being here. And so in front of us, I don't know if you can see all these championship belts. Maybe take down the phone number just for a couple of minutes. And that's just a small sample of the belts that he brought today. He has four more in a large suitcase that he brought here with his family. And what are these belts here that they represent? What? The amateur fights, right?
Yes. Each bout is probably three or four fights at a tournament in a matter of 3 years.
Yeah.
And each bout represents each different type of tournament, like each different weight class and different opponents, and usually sometimes it's the same opponents and sometimes it's not. And this is from Tennessee. I don't know if you guys can see it.
Oops, careful there.
It's from Tennessee.
That one there, okay, move it to your right just slightly. I'll hold the mic. Yeah, that one there. That one's from Tennessee?
Yes, each title is a national title.
Each one of these belts represents a national title.
Yes, which would took a lot of work to win and about 3 to 4 fights to win.
Go ahead and take that down so we could see it there a little more clearly. Maybe kind of hold it up there a little bit to your camera. There you go, right there. I'm just going to move this out of the way here just a little bit. Okay, go ahead and take his camera. Right there in the corner there. See that? Yeah, no, right there. Yeah, so that's the Tennessee belt. That's just a reference. Go ahead and hold it up there. That's fine. So it takes a lot of hard work and dedication to win one of these belts. How many do you have altogether, like 7 or 8?
The bouts, I have about 8, and I have 3 gold medals.
3 gold medals, 8 belts. It's amazing. And so how is it that it came about that you got chosen to go over with who to St. Petersburg, Russia?
There's a tournament at the beginning of the year in January in Reno, Nevada, called the Junior World Championships. And if winning that tournament, which I had about 25 in my bracket from all over the nation, and winning that tournament, you get to go on, and that's your ticket to Russia for be on Team USA.
Right, and here you are in action. I believe you're in the red outfit here in this video, right? Go ahead and take a look there. Are you in the red there?
Yes, that's me.
That's you. Where is that fight taking place?
That's taking place in Charleston, West Virginia.
Wow, that's amazing. We got a call coming in here. You got a fan already. All right, caller, go ahead. You're on the air.
Mark, quick question. What are your plans in the future? I'm pretty sure you're going to either try to, if you get enough, going to go into the pros. I understood that your dad is the one that trains you. How young did you start as far as boxing? And one more question is, how do you think you'll do in Russia?
Great.
Okay.
How young did you start, and how are you going to do in Russia, do you think, as we look at this action here? You're fighting quite well in this match, but go ahead and pick up what the caller asked.
Okay. I got introduced to the sport of boxing at the age of 4.
Wow.
Very young.
What'd you do, beat up your brother or something?
Dad had his friend, and they would just throw us in the ring, and we would fight.
Wow.
And when I got my first fight when I was 8, another fight when I was 9, and then 10. When I turned 11, I started taking off, going to a lot of different tournaments. And then 12, that's when I started winning national titles.
I'll bet kids at Sunnyside High School, I bet they don't mess with you, right?
So, yes.
Go ahead.
And the other question is, in Russia, I think I'll do very well because I have God on my side. And also, I have been getting feedback but from other coaches that I would do well with my style of fighting, of going forward aggressive and keep on throwing punches.
Oh, we got to take a break? Okay. You're very aggressive in your style of fighting. I want to talk to you about that a little bit when we come back, and then we're going to bring one of your coaches on. He's going to talk about you too.
Okay.
So we're talking with Mark Castro, 16-year-old from Sunnyside High School. He is going to St. Petersburg, Russia. What a trip for a teenager, and he'll be boxing there at the World Boxing Championships, trying to bring a championship belt home, another one so he can display. Back with your phone calls and our show after this from McGill Guzman McGill.
Have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights. With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from McGill Guzman McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
We need help to find this missing child. Delano Wilson was 1 month old when he went missing. He was last seen in Indianapolis, Indiana, August 27th of 2014. If you have any information, please call the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children at 1-800-THE-LOST. That's 1-800-843-5678. Please help bring Delano Wilson home.
When you're looking for KitchenAid innovation and quality, who has the answers, the selection, the price? Ventura TV Appliance. With billions in nationwide appliance buying power, more than Home Depot and Best Buy combined, we'll help you save. Our low prices on ENERGY STAR qualified KitchenAid appliances save you energy and money, and pay no interest on select models when paid in full within 12 months. Ventura TV Appliance, serving you since 1951.
Doctor TV on over the air channel 13.9.
Ventura TV Appliance Center. We're the save energy, save time, save money place. The ENERGY STAR qualified number one rated high efficiency cabrio from Whirlpool Place. You heard right. Right now, save big on select Whirlpool cabrio laundry pairs and pay no interest when paid in full within 6 months. At the hometown low price, think outside the big box place. Since 1951, Ventura TV Appliance Center. We're working hard to be your place.
Hello, I'm John Walsh. We need your help to capture this fugitive. Julio Cesar Guevara Mejia is wanted by the FBI in Sacramento for the attempted murder of a 19-year-old female in November of 2007. Police say he lured the young woman to a hotel room where he shot her three times in the chest. He could be in Palm Springs, California or Houston, Texas. Contact the FBI at 1-800-CALL-FBI if you have any information.
Hey, one sure way to make sure that no one in school messes with you, my friends, is just to take up boxing. Because if they do, you know what? One punch and you can just deck them, right? Right, Mark? No. I'm not encouraging that. I'm just kind of joking around here. Probably bad sense of humor on my part. But Mark Castro is here. He's right here. He's 16 years old, Sunnyside High School. His trainer is here, Marcos Padilla. And Marcos, let me start with you because you helped train him. You guide him. You're going to St. Petersburg, Russia with him. We're going to roll a videotape. I love those green boxing shoes there that you have here. What kind of boxer is he, Marcos? How would you describe him and say within a minute here?
Mark's a very aggressive fighter.
In what way?
Aggressive, like putting a lot of pressure.
with his opponents. But at the same way, at the same time, he a lot of head movement. So a lot of there's a lot of pressure fires. They go forward, but they get hit at the same time. With Mark, we try to work with him, you know, moving around, you know, lateral movement. So he, pressure fighter, but moving his head side to side, kind of like Mike Tyson a little bit, you know, but better.
He fights like Mike Tyson, a little bit.
Well, not.
He's bullying his way forward.
Yes. But moving his head side to side.
Moving his head side to side to dodge any potential punches coming his way. And at the same time, aggressively punching either left with the left or a right or whatever.
Correct.
Right?
Yes.
And he's counter.
Yeah,
he's able to counterpunch.
Counterpunch, you know, because you only have, 2 minutes in a round in these amateurs, so you have to be really busy.
How is it that with these two-minute rounds, how do you size up an opponent within, because these are what?
You only have 10 seconds.
how many rounds are there? Two?
Two.
Three two-minute rounds.
Correct.
Okay. Roll a videotape again, because we have several clips of you, and I like those green. What's up with those green boxing shoes, by the way? Yeah. What's up with that?
It's like, my parents told me, don't get those shoes. But I seen that, I'm like, those shoes don't match anything, so they match everything.
Yes, Trey, go ahead.
Yeah, I get it, I understand. But so with the, getting back to my original question, Marcos, so you have 3 2-minute rounds, it gives you zero time to know what your opponent is about.
Yeah, but sometimes you get a chance to see, if you see them fight a different opponent before you fight that, sometimes you can see them, the way they fight their style.
Yeah.
Sometimes you get that opportunity, because it's a bracket. So you could fight and say you're gonna fight out of those, whoever wins out of those two guys. And so you kind of see the way they fight. So sometimes you get a chance to get a glimpse of the opponent you're gonna fight next.
Yeah.
That's if you're lucky.
Yeah. Who taught him how to box?
His dad. His dad is the one who, brought him up as a boxer. Now he's been with me for maybe 7 months, 8 months now. He came with the team right here, Marquitos Boxing in D-Throne. And now he's with us and, here we are going to Russia.
If he has a weakness, what would it be?
I can't tell you that. No, but
his opponents are in Russia. They can't hear us.
Yeah, I know. No, but
what would it be? Because obviously he has a great attitude.
No,
he's a great kid.
Yeah, he's a great kid, good work ethics, and everything is doing good. I just he's young right now.
But everybody has a weakness. What would you say his is? Something that he needs to work on. Not much, huh?
Maybe just tighten up a little bit more of his punches, a little bit, that's about it.
Yeah. I mean, he has 8 national championship belts already. He's got how many gold medals?
3 gold medals.
3 gold medals? I mean, he's Marcos, he's doing something right.
Oh, well, yeah, he's good. That's what I'm saying. It's kind of hard to pick a spot.
It's amazing. But, yeah. I mean, you as a trainer, though, see different things that he would see.
No, for sure.
As a boxer, because you're kind of looking at it from the outside.
Yeah, for sure. I think tying up a little bit more of his punches.
Yeah, yeah, obviously. But, caller, go ahead. You're on with our two guests.
Good morning, John. And good morning, Mark. Congratulations to you. I did go to Sanger High School. I can't say where the gym is, but that's great. But I live near Sunnyside. Okay, question, couple of them. On the helmet, wherever you're going, I think you're going to Mexico?
St. Petersburg, right. Russia.
Russia? I'm so sorry.
Yeah,
I'm sorry. Russia. On the helmet, you wear it while you're boxing.
Yes.
Is that the way it works?
Yes, we wear a helmet, but our face is wide open.
So you can get hit in the face?
Yes, definitely.
Yeah. Go ahead, caller, go ahead.
Why can't everybody wear a helmet boxing? Like when you get older in professional boxing, is there any reason why that couldn't happen? And I think it should. I hate to see you without a helmet boxing, honestly.
Yeah.
I'm paranoid.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. I know maybe I'm thinking unlogically. I don't know.
Yeah.
But I thank you.
No, you know
John
what? That's
Mark.
That's a great question, because I've wondered that for years, that same question, caller. So as we continue to look at you with these green boxing shoes, I happen to like them, and I'll tell you what it reminds me of. Reminds me of the time when Muhammad Ali was fighting and was wearing those white boxing shoes with the red tassels. I used to love those because they stood out. Your boxing shoes stand out. We know who you are and where you are, but why don't professional boxers wear a helmet like this?
Well, that separates professional boxers from amateur boxers, because if they're not good enough in the amateurs, then that's keeping them safe in the pros, so they won't have to get all the concussions like all the boxers. So they don't have helmets, the professionals, because that's what separates a sport. And professionals, you won't get helmets, but you get even better. Like, there's some professional boxers that don't really get hit, like as Floyd Mayweather, so that's why he's very good. And he hardly gets touched that much. And the helmets just separate you from the... In amateur boxing, they started taking off the helmets when you start turning at the age of 19 and older. So you don't... So eventually there will not be helmets in amateurs.
Marcos, what do you think? Should the pros wear them?
I think pros should put out a headgear. It'd be fine because I guess it's more entertaining for the
viewer. Yeah. Caller, go ahead. Short on time, so make the question rather speedy or quick if you can.
How's the scoring? How do you score a hit? In other words, I know the amateur. And number two, do you get sponsors to send you where you're going to go?
Great. Two great questions. Gosh, thank you. So how does the scoring work? Marcos, maybe you can address that, scoring.
They change it as time went on. Before, it was just a point. They used to have a clicker, and they'll see how many points you got by you hitting them. But they changed it because they're very controversial fights.
So each hit counts as a point?
Yeah, that was before, but now they're starting to do a 10-9 system, like professional now. They changed that system.
So now it's changed now.
Now it's a 10-9 system now.
Interesting. So if you win the round, it's 10-9.
Yeah.
Okay.
One gets 10 and one gets 9, yeah.
Maybe you can answer the caller's question about sponsors. Did you get a sponsor to go over there?
Sponsorship. Team USA is paying for all my some of my expenses, and we're trying to send our Marcos with me for me to feel comfortable. And
what weight class are you in?
I'm in the bantamweight, 119, 54 kilograms.
Right. And I know you want to promote that boxing gym. You're wearing the T-shirt there. What's the name of that boxing gym?
It's called D-Throne here in Fresno. It's D-Throne Marquitos Boxing. There's one here on Bullard and Marks and Bullard in Kings Canyon.
And also the Sanger Boxing Club is well known, obviously.
Of course,
and you've been there for years, but you also go to D-Throne. So two great places. When Mark is fighting, Marcos, tell me what you advise him to do before each match. Is there any one particular thing that you constantly go over with him, and don't forget this, don't forget that, but stay focused on it? What's the one thing that you
just make sure his punches are nice and tight, you know, chin down, you know, be aggressive, you know, confidence, obviously, you know, I think 90% is mentally, and then just go there and have fun.
Yeah, I got to ask you about professional boxing. You're only 16. You ever scared you're going to get hurt?
Well, definitely, yeah. You could be scared, but that's what training is for. And I had to train hard, so I could give the punishment in the ring, not get it. And professional, I would like to go to the Olympics first and represent Team USA in 2020 in Tokyo, Japan.
Could he be a professional boxer? Should he be?
He should. I mean, he's doing all the hard work. Why not him? Keep him back if he loves doing it?
How much hard work does it take? How much dedication?
You know what, this kid, he has a lot of dedication. I'm very impressed the way his work ethics and the way he gets up in the morning. He gets up in the morning every day.
Runs?
And runs every day.
Rocky?
Just like Rocky. So, you know, he has the will and the want to become a great.
Marcos, we're out of time, but I want to thank you for coming.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you. You're doing a great job with this kid here.
We're trying our best.
All right. D-Throne Boxing Club.
D-Throne Boxing.
There you go. Mark, you know what we think of you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And congratulations to you and your parents. They're raising a great, young, honest, and very humble gentleman here. Mark Castro, 16 years old, Sunnyside High, going to St. Petersburg, Russia next Friday, September the 4th. We wish him well. Back tomorrow. Our show is on breast cancer. See you then, and thank you to Chuck McGill for the sponsorship. Have a great day.